Well, in the previous lectures, let's see what we have seen. Just revise in brief, very, very brief, that we have started our discussion with this type of devices or the techniques where different types of electromagnetic radiations are being used. So we started with first device that is said to be the microwave oven. We have learned how microwave oven works, what is the basic physics principle that is used to generate heat inside food items using microwaves, and that is able to, or that is sufficient, that heat generated is sufficient to cook that food, and it is easy way of cooking of the food as compared to the traditional way. We have seen its advantages, disadvantages too, the methods, etc., etc. Then the second important device we have seen where radio waves are used, that is called as radar. Microwaves or radios are also used. So radar is another very important equipment that is used at several different locations, maybe in industry, maybe in military, maybe at airport or any other locations. These radars are very nicely used to detect several, that because of the for the surveillance, to keep the watch on different type of things and surveillance. There are several applications. This is what the expression we have seen, to find out the power radiated and power transmitted and power received. So that is what this type of expression. Don't go into details of derivation of this expression, that is not part of our discussion. Now there are two different types we have seen. First is primary surveillance radar, and second is the secondary surveillance radar. Secondary surveillance radar is two-way communication. That means the target and radar communicates with each other, and thereby detecting and ranging of that type of objects is very easy and possible. So this is more prominent and simple and popular way of popular device, which is called as secondary surveillance radar. We have seen its applications. There are, other than that, there are several other applications like civilian use, military use, scientific uses, remote sensing, law enforcement agencies, they also use radars. Land use, forestry, agriculture, this type of mapping, whatever different types of maps we see that are published by government or several different types of agencies, that uses this type of radar techniques with the help of satellites. Then another important application we have seen, that is third one, that is pyroelectric thermometer, where ceramic type of pyroelectric materials are used, which materials generate electricity when they receive certain radiations of certain wavelengths. So physical principle of that also we have seen. And nowadays this new technology, that is Internet of Things, that is coming in, and this technology very widely uses this type of pyroelectric thermometers, either in sensors or in camera, to detect temperature, to detect motion, and lot many other things are there. Several different types of things can be controlled using this type of IoT devices, where these pyroelectric thermometers are very basically used. Ceramic materials, we have seen how, what happens to these materials when certain radiations come in, or that radiation interact with this type of ceramic material. Because of this polarization tendency or property of this type of compounds or materials, there occurs an electricity, and that produces a signal, and further it can be amplified, it can be classified, and other technical things are possible. In that case, we have seen this relation, M is equal to mu into capital A into H. What mu is, what A is, what H is, everything is written there. And these are certain applications, as we have shown. Motion sensors for security purposes, infrared thermometers, or the measuring temperature of extremely hot bodies or moving object. So the thermal scanner nowadays we are using because of this COVID situation. That is basically an infrared thermometer. So that thermometer doesn't touch the, we are not needed to touch the patient or anyone else to measure his body, his or her body temperature, and that particular thermometer uses all these type of techniques. Now, as I said, we have shown, I have shown one such YouTube also, and that YouTube gives you what is the actual ceramic type of these pyrometers, pyrometer thermometers. So that particular tube also you might have observed in the last lecture, that will be available. My lectures will be made available on YouTube too later on, as I mention when I finish all this particular chapter. So now let's go to the fourth important thing, that is called as X-ray radiography. Now X-ray radiography is again a simple, very simple technique. Just like we use optical camera, in optical camera we use optical light to photograph a particular thing, and here we use X-rays in spite of optical radiations. same technique. That means you have to expose certain some material, and you have to on the film itself you have to get something. In optical camera, what happens? Light is thrown on that particular object, or if it is a natural object, a natural light, this light gets reflected on into the camera, and the film is kept inside the camera. That film is exposed for a very short of time, and according a particular image is generated on that. That means there is exposure of to the light coming in from that object on that particular film, and that film is now further developed, and we can generate a photograph. That is the technique used in optical camera. Here also, we have to send the X-rays through that object, and at the other end, that means X-ray tube where these X-rays are generated, and the photographic plate which is kept away. So there is in between, that particular object is to be kept, either animal or human or any other object. That particular film is to be exposed by these X-rays through that object, and where this particular thickness of that object is very very small, or that allows X-rays to pass through that particular portion of X-rays pass through that object and film gets exposed. Whereas certain regions or certain objects there are in that object which block this X-rays, and therefore that particular type part of the film doesn't get exposed. So photographing, so this is what an X-ray photography actually. So it is radiography, or it is called as photography, where X-rays are used to expose the film in between. This is called as weld, W-E-L-D, object or anything else. We are going to draw its diagram as well. So that particular X-ray photography is another very important technique in physics as well as in the medical science. Nowadays, whenever we go into the hospital and we go for X-ray radiography, or we go for this X-ray, in that case we use same technique. For a fraction of second, the particular object or a human is exposed and to the X-rays, and its film is developed, X-ray film is developed, and based upon that we can identify what is the breakage, whether the bone is broken, whether it's hairline fracture, or whether it's a regular type of big fracture, everything. So this orthopedics person that uses X-ray, that X-ray is again a photography technique or radiography technique, which of which we are going to see into details of that. Okay, so let's write in very very brief. We'll write very brief about this X-ray radiography. X-ray radiography involves the use of VES, involves the use of invisible, okay, because this is not visible radiation. Visible photography is different one. That is what we use our camera. Here it is invisible, highly penetrating energetic radiations, highly penetrating. This involves invisible, highly penetrating short wavelength of EM radiations non-destructively, destructively. That means we are not supposed to destruct this object. Okay, so that's what, for a very small fraction of second, this particular object is to be illuminated or irradiated with this X-rays, not for permanent, not for longer time. Whenever this happens, this X-rays may cause a harm to that particular type of object, maybe human or maybe animal or anything. So that's why we use this word non-destructively. To obtain an image of healing details, an image of hidden details. This is the basic definition of this. So here we can show this diagram. This is what you can draw this diagram. We'll write about this diagram as well. First, let's draw this diagram. Very simple diagram. There is an X-ray tube. Tube is usually shown like this. This is an object that is shown to be a tube as like this. So in our textbook we can see this entire diagram. Here this is an object, photographic plate, sorry, this metal plate, and there is a filament which gives out, this is which are this positive and negative, if the current is provided to this, this throws this electronic thermionic emission, and now this metal plate gives out the x-rays. And here this is an platform where this object is kept. Okay, so this is called as a weld, weld, weld. It may be a human, try to understand, this may be a human, and below that there is a one rack or something, some agency, some part is there. This is called as the x-ray film. Actually it is very, thickness is very very small, but just to understand this, this is the x-ray film, x-ray film, and this is a stand. Usually we do not look this, it is below this particular case. Okay, x-ray film, or this is called as stand or x-ray film holder, film holder. Okay, and now these x-rays produce, these x-rays fall here. Okay, in a very small time, as I mentioned just now, these are the x-rays, and some of the x-rays pass through this, on this photographic plate. Okay, so now where there is an strong, this dense object, there on this part will be remain as it is, whereas this is a thin part, the x-rays can pass through that, this x-ray reaches here, and that is how on this photographic plate we get this human bone is shown to be like this. Okay, so this is the bone shown here. Okay, this is a black part and this is the white part. This is white part and this is the black part. Okay, this is a bone image, bone image. And if there is a break, this break can be shown by this. So that is how this particular very simple technique, we are supposed to radiate x-rays on that object which is to be filmed, and that particular object, depending upon its thickness, whether it allows to pass x-rays through it or not. If it is allows, the film gets exposed, and that's what it becomes, a completely black. When this particular x-rays are blocked by that object, then that part of the film remains white or whatever color, and accordingly we get black and white film of this particular x-rays. Try to understand, black and white films are only exposed or only received at the end when this particular object is screened to this x-rays in this particular technique. Okay, now let's write in brief about this, very very brief. Radiations are generated. Okay, these radiations are generated using x-ray tube or apparatus. Then it is transmitted. Through the sample of interest. Okay, and that is called as weld, weld. That is called as weld. Okay, it may be human or animal or object, anything. So weld is either human, animal or object, that is to be kept in between photographic plate and this x-ray tube, which emits this x-ray. Okay. Then it is transmitted through the sample of interest, weld, that is human, either human, animal or object, where it is, okay, I am using second time this word, attenuated. Where it is attenuated, that means some radiations are, some part of the radiation is blocked, some part of radiation is tried, is allowed to pass through that object. Attenuated, depending upon, attenuated depending upon density of that object, structure and thickness. And thickness of materials. Okay, so some part of radiations are allowed to transmit, some part is blocked. So where it is blocked, that gives you image of that object, and where it is not blocked, that gives you black part in this. So black and white film is developed, or we get at the end of this. Okay, so this is what a particular material is. So we can write here areas where more radiations are transmitted, X-ray radiations is transmitted. It's transmitted produces darker area on this photographic film, okay, X-ray film. On X-ray film, and when radiations are blocked or not allowed to pass through that object, the part of film becomes white, okay, and that's why we get black and white image. We receive this black and white image because of this type of X-ray radiations, as we have shown here. Okay, and let's write one more paragraph. In hospitals, we are supposed to use this type of techniques. We usually use this technique in hospitals, and therefore that is called as conventional radiography. Nowadays, these devices are so sophisticated that it becomes this technique where we use photographic plate or this particular type of X-ray film, and then we expose all this. This is called as X-ray radiography. When this system is connected to the computer, we get entire image of this object on the computer with its interpretation and not many analysis. Then it becomes a computerized tomography, that is called as CT scan. We are going to discuss more about this later on. Okay, now next, conventional radiography makes use of transmitted radiation. That is what we have repeating this. Makes use of transmitted radiation to expose X-ray film. This is ordinary film which is used in our cameras, for optical camera, same film is there, X-ray film, only size of that is bigger one, which is developed using photographic techniques. And we know that this particular developing process requires certain time. That's why after we go for this X-ray examination, we have to wait at least 15 minutes, 20 minutes, depending upon the situation, to get that particular film to be developed. So this process of development of X-ray film is exactly similar process where we use this optical camera photographic techniques for development. That is what the technique is called as photographic techniques. In photography, we use this technique to develop such type of film. Same technique is used here too. Okay, so using photographic techniques. This is more established. Hundreds of years, almost 120 years, this technique is being used. This is more established technique, well known for its medical applications. For its medical applications. And laboratory equipment involved. Laboratory equipment involved are less expensive. Okay, याचा अर्थ असा आहे आपल्याकडे जो एक्सरे आपण काढतो कुठल्याही हॉस्पिटलमध्ये तिथं लागणारी मशीनरी फारशी किंमतची नसते, म्हणजे किंमत असतेच पण फार महाग नसते, त्यामुळे या प्रकारचं टेक्निक खूप वाईडली वापरलं जातं या प्रकारचे डिटेक्ट फ्लॉज डिटेक्ट करण्यासाठी किंवा मेडिकल लॅबोरेटरीमध्ये वापरतात. अँड दिस पर्टिक्युलर टेक्निक इज अ व्हेरी सिम्पल टेक्निक वेअर वी यूज एक्सरेज टू फोटोग्राफ दॅट पर्टिक्युलर ऑब्जेक्ट इन स्पाइट ऑफ ऑप्टिकल रेडिएशन. दॅट सिम्पल टेक्निक इज कॉल्ड एज एक्सरे रेडिओग्राफी. अपवर फ्रॉम दॅट, एज आय सेड, दिस एक्सरे रेडिओग्राफी हॅज अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ अदर ऍप्लिकेशन्स टू. वी विल लिस्ट सम ऑफ दॅम. त्याच्यातले काही ऍप्लिकेशन्स आपण थोडेसे डिटेलमध्ये बघूया. वन ऑफ द ऍप्लिकेशन दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज एक्सरे क्रिस्टोलोग्राफी, दॅट इज वॉट वी आर मोर इंटरेस्टेड अँड विल लुक वन बाय वन इन डिटेल. So, in dental surgery, okay, you might have seen, तुम्ही पाहिलं असेल ज्यावेळेस आपण कुठल्याही दाताच्या डॉक्टरकडे जातो आणि दातामध्ये काय प्रॉब्लेम आहे हे टेस्ट करत असेल, तेवढ्या दातापुरता एक छोटासा एक्सरे घेतात. ए व्हेरी स्मॉल मशीन इज देअर, विद इन फ्रॅक्शन ऑफ सेकंड दॅट टेक्स अ फोटोग्राफ अँड दॅट डिटेक्ट्स व्हॉट आर द फ्लॉज, व्हॉट आर द प्रॉब्लेम्स एटसेट्रा इन युअर टीथ, अँड दॅट्स वाय इट कॅन बी यूज इन डेंटल सर्जरी. दॅट इज फर्स्ट ऍप्लिकेशन. Second, in orthopedics. Whose microphone is on?
नरेंद्र मोदी स्टेडियम में हमने अंग्रेजों का जो हाल किया है उसे देखने के बाद नीरव मोदी वापस करें.
ठीक आहे, लेट्स सी इन ऑर्थोपेडिक्स. देन इन ऑर्थोपेडिक्स डिटेक्टिंग बुलेट्स इन ह्युमन्स. शरीरामध्ये ज्या गोळ्या शिरतात बंदुकीच्या त्यांचं डिटेक्शन करता येतं. ऑर फॉर डिटेक्टिंग बुलेट्स फॉरेन ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन ह्युमन बॉडी. ओके, नॉट ओनली इन ऑर्थोपेडिक्स बट दॅट इज व्हॉट द मेडिकल ऍप्लिकेशन्स. X-rays are used in cancer treatment. Okay, I'm not mentioning everything. That means there are several different types of techniques, different tumors and lot many things are there. Or these unwanted cells in human body should be exposed or to be exposed for some longer time. Using this X-rays, and that destroys this type of cells, and therefore this the treatment of cancer sometimes, in some cases, X-rays can be used here. This is another very important medical application of this. Then fourth, in security systems at airport. इफ समवन हॅज सीन दॅट, तुम्ही जर कोणी पाहिलं असेल एअरपोर्टवरती आपल्या लगेजचं जे स्कॅनिंग होतं, दॅट स्कॅनिंग इज डन युझिंग दिस एक्सरेज अँड इट्स फोटोग्राफ्स आर टेकन इफ रिक्वायर्ड. ओके, अँड दॅट शोज यू वेदर दिस यू आर हॅडिंग समथिंग वेपन ऑर समथिंग एक्सप्लोजिव्ह मटेरियल एक्सेट्रा इज टेकन विथ द लगेज ऑर सम नार्कोटिक्स टाईप ऑफ मटेरियल दॅट ऑल्सो कॅन बी आयडेंटिफाईड युझिंग दिस टाईप ऑफ एक्सरे सिक्युरिटी सिस्टम्स. सो इट इज वन ऑफ द व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट ऍप्लिकेशन ऑफ दिस. देन fifth application is in archaeology. Spelling of that is archeo, archaeological investigation. archaeological investigation. Okay, these are very general applications. And last application which we are going to concentrate upon is, that is sixth application I am writing here. This is called as X-ray diffraction technique. X-ray diffraction, or that is called as crystallography. Crystallography. And this is one of the very important principle. As I said in the beginning, the Watson and Crick, these are the two persons who were responsible for identifying the structure of DNA, human DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid. So the structure of DNA could be found out using X-rays by these particular persons, where they use this X-ray diffraction technique. Now, what is this X-ray diffraction technique? Certain materials are to be exposed for some time by the X-rays, and there happens the phenomenon of diffraction, which is called as X-ray diffraction. And diffracted beams of X-rays are to be incident upon certain photographic plate, and we get a very regular pattern on the this particular X-ray photographic plate, which is used in the X-ray diffraction pattern or X-ray crystallography. And depending, just making this analysis of that particular image obtained of that object, we can study internal structure of that. And that is why we can draw this simple diagram that tells you how this X-ray diffraction is used there. Okay, now here I can show these are the different atoms of a particular element. This is an array of atoms. These atoms are placed in such a manner, regular structure is there. So this forms a layer, layer 1, layer 2, layer 3, etc. This is how we are using this. Okay, so this works as a diffraction grating. Now X-rays incident here and get reflected because of this atom. Another X-ray gets reflected here, gets reflected. So this is incident beam. This is the diffracted beam. This is a diffraction, not reflection. Diffraction beam. Okay, and these are the atoms, or that is crystal, regular crystal. And using this technique of diffraction, we can so this diffracted beam is to be obtained on some plate, some photographic plate. Here we get a regular pattern in the this type of case. Okay, and studying this pattern, we identify whether the structure is this type of simple cubic structure. There are so many other things I won't go to discuss of this, whether the structure of the given material is like this, or this is called a simple cubic. Then there is a body center cubic, that is called as BCC, FCC, face centered cubic, then rhombohedron, or etc. Different types of structures are there possible. So this is a technique which is very widely used in nowadays in material science, in solid state physics, etc., where we can study this internal structure. So this is called as interplanar distance, this D, and this gives you the structure of that particular crystal or that material or that compound, and we can identify what that particular type of compound is or its structure is, either it is body centered cubic, face centered cubic, or rhombohedron. And other physical properties of that material can be investigated using this X-ray diffraction. For example, in laboratory we are carrying out certain reaction, we are generating certain compound, and if you use this compound, or if we scan this compound under this X-ray diffraction pattern, we can understand its what type of different crystals these are, and depending upon its utility and its application, different types of crystals can be generated. Some crystals are generated naturally to identify their structure, we use X-ray diffraction. Some crystals are generated in the laboratory, are manufactured in the laboratory, and investigation of that also can be done with this X-ray diffraction technique. Okay, so more about this you will learn when we go into TYBSC or in higher studies, where we can go for this type of structure, which is called as here. This is called as X-ray diffraction, and more about this you will learn in TYBSC in solid state physics, how this X-ray diffraction techniques is used. One more very important thing I would like to suggest to you, that in our laboratory, that means in our department, not in department, but in our college, we have a central instrumentation facility where these type of different devices are being in used. So you can, some other time when you come in the college, as I said earlier, we can visit this particular laboratory where different types of devices are being used, and these devices are being using different types of physical principles, in which we have this X-ray diffraction machine too. And how to use this machine, how it gives different types of parameters, how it is connected to the computer, what are different types of softwares available for that. These things are, and again, a specialized study. We are not going to introduce all these things here, but this is what the application of this X-ray diffraction. So as we have gone for this X-ray radiography, this is another very important application. So six such applications we have generated or we have seen here. Okay, now give a next. This is a fifth application, number five. This is called as computer tomography. Computer tomography. COMPUTER. Computer tomography. Or that is called as CT scan. Okay. The word very widely used in medical physics today, that is called as CT scan. Now, what is this CT scan? We are going to look into details. Okay. Now, remember, I would like to tell you something more about this. We are going to see some diagrams as well, if it is possible. So, what is computerized? So, now the difference between X-ray radiography and computerized tomography is very little. Little in the sense, this is an advanced technique. In spite of exposing that object only for a fraction of a second, here we expose this object almost in all directions, all possible directions, 360 degree angle, and then such type of field, these images are generated using computers. So we are not using photographic plates here, we are using computer monitor or computer where this type of images are generated, and therefore another detailed analysis of this type of objects can be done here. And that's why this particular technique is called as computerized or computer tomography, or that is called as CT scan. And in medical physics, it has large number of applications. So what is this? This is what written in definition from taken from Wikipedia. A computerized tomography or CT scan combines a series of X-ray images taken from different angles around your body and uses computer processing to create cross-sectional images or slices, okay, and of the bones, blood vessels and soft tissues inside your body. CT scan images provide more detailed information than the plain X-rays do. So what we do with this X-ray radiography, more detailed study of the human organs, bones or tissues or blood vessels, etc. can be done. Its cross-sectional images are taken, and these images are generated using the certain softwares on the computers, and its detailed study is possible as compared to the other technique, which is X-ray radiography. And this particular technique is called as the computerized tomography. For that sense, I'll show you some devices. This one such device I would like to show you. Just tell me whether you are looking at it or not. Just a minute. Yeah, I think this. So let's go for certain images. See, this is what the device, I'll show one of this such device here. This is the machine which is called as X-ray tomography machine. How does a CT or CT scan work? This type of website is there. We can go for this electron. Now, what is CT scan? See this. This is a machine, CT scan, and this is a fellow or the person who is to be scanned. Either his head is to be scanned, his chest is to be scanned, or his other body parts are to be scanned. He is allowed to, this X-ray source, as well as it's a photographic, this sensor receiver is there, transmitter and receiver, and through that particular transmitter and receiver, this human body goes, okay, in among different angles. So this machine rotates itself, and under this rotation, it scans each and every body part here. And likewise, you can go for all these types of testing. And see this, the images are generated are like this. These are the three-dimensional images also can be generated there. So more detailed study of these objects, the body parts,
that can be seen here as compared to this X-rays. In X-rays, only bones are detected. Maybe other body parts may not come there. Their imaging may not be possible. But in the CT scan, a detailed study of all these things can be seen here. Okay, so this is how you can see. This is what a 3D diagram, three-dimensional diagram, and this is what the lungs. So lungs are scanned. And what are these are the white sections shown in the lung. This is what a certain problem. Now this is to be identified by physician, and further medical treatment is to be gone through this. Otherwise, in X-ray radiography, we won't see this. आपल्याला एक्सरे मध्ये एवढा डिटेल त्याचा अभ्यास करता येत नाही. सिटी स्कॅन मध्ये मात्र अतिशय मायन्यूट डिटेल्स प्रत्येक ऑर्गनचे प्रत्येक ऑब्जेक्ट्सचे दिसतात, अँड देअर फॉर फर्दर स्टडी अँड फर्दर मेडिकेशन इज व्हेरी पॉसिबल. ओके, सॉफ्ट टिश्यूज, द पेल्विस, ब्लड वेसल्स, लंग्स, ब्रेन, ॲबडोमेन, बोन्स एटसेट्रा, दीज आर द डिफरंट टाइप्स ऑफ पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी विच कॅन बी स्कॅन व्हेरी नाईसली, अँड वॉट एव्हर डिफेक्ट्स, वॉट एव्हर प्रॉब्लेम, डिसीज एटसेट्रा, दॅट कॅन बी आयडेंटिफाईड by a that radiographer or that particular CT scan, and then a particular person or the doctor which under which we are taking this treatment, that goes for a treatment for that. Okay, CT versus MRI, this is another scanning type of technique. MRI scanning is different one. CT scan is basically, okay, so a CT scan uses X-rays, but MRI uses magnets and radio waves. That is the difference. This is not part of our study. Unlike an MRI, CT scan does not show tendons or and the ligaments. Okay, this is what limitation. Okay, this is what actually compare of this. We don't want to go for that, but I just want to show some more images to you that how this CT scan is done. Okay, these are the different devices, and that is shown here. Different types of devices, CT scan devices are available. Patient is fixed and that device rotates, that device moves, and that scans each and every part of the human body. There is a vertical movement, there is horizontal movement, there is rotational movement, all that type of movements of machines are possible depending upon different techniques, and thereby a human parts of the different parts of the human body are found to be seen there. Okay, this is one more diagram I do want to show here. More about this we are going to write in the next lecture in very brief, but there are several different types of information is available on the internet. You can look here. Now this spine imaging technique, X-rays, MRIs and CT scan. So CT scan, how this particular technique is used here. Okay, spine X-rays, spinal MRI and spinal CT scan. So on the internet, you can go for learning all these types of aspects of this study where we use this CT scan techniques. Okay, apart from that, let me look whether there is any film on this CT scan. YouTube. CT scan technique. I'll take Hindi. मी हिंदी मधला घेतो म्हणजे आपल्याला सगळ्यांना समजायला थोडस सोपं होईल. CT scan. See this. CT scan कैसे होता है.
CT scan के बारे में आप लोगों ने कभी ना कभी जरूर सुना होगा, और आप में से कुछ लोगों ने ये स्कैन कराया भी होगा. सो आज के इस वीडियो में हम बात करने वाले हैं कि सीटी स्कैन क्या होता है, क्यों कराया जाता है, कैसे कराया जाता है, और सीटी स्कैन कर
दिसत नहीं है.
नो सर.
ओके, आई विल टेक केयर ऑफ दिस. लेट मी स्टॉप शेयरिंग दिस. वंस अगेन आई स्टार्ट दिस विंडो एंड नाउ दिस शेयर. जस्ट टेल मी जस्ट मिनट. आता दिसते का बघा.
यस सर.
कभी ना कभी जरूर सुना होगा, और आप में से कुछ लोगों ने ये स्कैन कराया भी होगा. सो आज के इस वीडियो में हम बात करने वाले हैं कि सीटी स्कैन क्या होता है, क्यों कराया जाता है, कैसे कराया जाता है, और सीटी स्कैन कराने में कितना खर्च आता है. तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं. सीटी स्कैन का पूरा नाम है कंप्यूटराइज्ड टोमोग्राफी स्कैन. ये एक ऐसा टेस्ट है जिसमें कंप्यूटर और घूमती हुई एक्सरे मशीन की सहायता से शरीर के अलग अलग भागों की क्रॉस सेक्शनल यानी टुकड़ों में इमेजेस ली जाती है. नॉर्मल एक्सरे इमेज के मुकाबले सीटी स्कैन में ज्यादा डिटेल्स और क्लियर जानकारी हासिल होती है. सीटी स्कैन में शरीर की सॉफ्ट सेल्स, ब्लड वेसल्स और हड्डियों से रिलेटेड डिसऑर्डर्स के फोटो क्लियर दिखाई पड़ते हैं. सिटी स्कैन का इस्तेमाल सिर, कंधे, रीढ़ की हड्डी, दिल, पेट, घुटने और छाती से जुड़ी प्रॉब्लम्स के डायग्नोसिस के लिए किया जाता है। आमतौर पर सीटी स्कैन से शरीर के हर एक हिस्से का क्लियर इमेज देखा जा सकता है और रोगों के डायग्नोसिस, चोट और सर्जिकल और रेडिएशन ट्रीटमेंट के लिए सीटी स्कैन किया जाता है। चलिए हम बात करते हैं कि सीटी स्कैन क्यों किया जाता है। शरीर में चोट और दूसरे डिसऑर्डर्स का इलाज शुरू करने से पहले डॉक्टर मरीज को सीटी स्कैन कराने की सलाह देते हैं। सीटी स्कैन की रिपोर्ट से ये क्लियर हो जाता है कि मरीज के शरीर का कौन सा भाग किस वजह से अफेक्टेड है। सीटी स्कैन में लगने वाला टाइम इस बात पर डिपेंड करता है कि शरीर के किस भाग का सीटी स्कैन किया जा रहा है। चलिए हम बात करते हैं कि सीटी स्कैन कैसे किया जाता है। सीटी स्कैन आमतौर पर हॉस्पिटल्स और रेडियोलॉजी क्लिनिक में किया जाता है। इस दौरान सीटी स्कैन कराने वाले पर्सन को सीटी स्कैन कराने से कुछ घंटे पहले तक कुछ खाने पीने से मना किया जाता है। इसके अलावा सीटी स्कैन होने से पहले पर्सन मेटल का अगर कोई जेवर पहना हो तो उसे उतार लिया जाता है। सीटी स्कैन रेडियोलॉजी टेक्नोलॉजिस्ट करते हैं। इस टेस्ट के दौरान एक बड़ी डोनट आकार वाली सीटी मशीन के अंदर एक टेबल पर लिटा दिया जाता है। सीटी स्कैन के दौरान एक नैरो एक्सरे बीम का इस्तेमाल किया जाता है जो शरीर के एक हिस्से के चारों ओर घूमता है। ये कई अलग अलग एंगल से इमेजेस की एक चैन बनाता है। शरीर के उस भाग का क्रॉस सेक्शनल इमेज बनाने के लिए कंप्यूटर इस जानकारी का यूज करता है। रोटी के एक टुकड़े की तरह कंप्यूटर भी शरीर के अंदर का 2D इमेज दिखाता है। कई टुकड़ों में इमेजेस हासिल करने के लिए ये प्रोसेस दोहराया जाता है। इसके बाद कंप्यूटर इन इमेजेस के स्कैन को 3D इमेज में बदल देता है जिन्हें डॉक्टर बहुत क्लियर तरीके से देख पाते हैं। इसमें हड्डियों, ब्लड वेसल्स के साथ साथ कई दूसरे हिस्सों की इमेजेस क्लियर दिखाई देती है। चलिए हम बात करते हैं कि शरीर के किन हिस्सों का सीटी स्कैन किया जाता है। सीटी स्कैन एक इमेजिंग टेक्निक है। इस टेक्निक के जरिए डॉक्टर्स कई समस्याओं का निदान करते हैं, जैसे कि दिमाग में चोट, खोपड़ी यानी स्कल फ्रैक्चर होने और ब्लीडिंग के डायग्नोसिस के लिए सीटी स्कैन किया जाता है। ब्रेन में ब्लड के क्लॉट्स और ब्रेन ट्यूमर और बढ़ी हुई ब्रेन वेंट्रिकल्स के डायग्नोसिस के लिए सीटी स्कैन किया जाता है। इन्फेक्शन, मांसपेशियों और जोड़ों में समस्या और हड्डियों में फ्रैक्चर और ट्यूमर के डायग्नोसिस के लिए सीटी स्कैन किया जाता है। ब्लड वेसल्स और दूसरे इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर की जांच के लिए सीटी स्कैन किया जाता है। अंदरूनी चोटों और अंदरूनी ब्लीडिंग के डायग्नोसिस के लिए सीटी स्कैन किया जाता है। सर्जरी और बायोप्सी जैसे प्रोसेस के बारे में जानने के लिए सीटी स्कैन किया जाता है। कैंसर और दिल के रोगों के साथ साथ कुछ दूसरी बीमारियों के उपचार की प्रभावशीलता का पता लगाने के लिए भी सीटी स्कैन किया जाता है। किसी एक्सीडेंट के बाद होने वाली इंटरनल ब्लीडिंग के डायग्नोसिस के लिए भी सीटी स्कैन किया जाता है। चलिए हम बात करते हैं कि सीटी स्कैन की कीमत क्या होती है, सीटी स्कैन कराने में कितना खर्चा आता है।
Stop here. Actually, this is not part of our learning. So here, see, this is what a CT scan or computerized tomography means. Now, drawing these diagrams and doing all these things may be difficult for us, but try to understand this is what the difference between the X-ray, radiography and CT scan. Now, what this machine, how these machines work, what are the different techniques, this will be again a part of the specialized study. That is, no, we are not expected to do here. From the examination point of view, only this definition is more important for you. So here, today we'll stop in today's lecture. In tomorrow's lecture, we will go more about this CT scan, some of the diagrams, some of the information of that will be right. And if required, we'll go for the another NASC device, that is the solar cell. So let me take the attendance, then we will stop here.